Hello friends, we are going to discuss static structural analysis of a tapered bar by using ANSYS mechanical APDL. So first of all, while starting this one, what we have to do is we have to create a folder that is already done here itself. Now we're starting from file, change directory. So by browsing, we have to go back to the folder what we have already created there. So it is in the desktop, like you can see down. Move downwards, you can see that folder is tapered bar. So all will be saved there itself. So whatever we'll be doing, that will be saved in the folder named tapered bar. Next one is we have to give the name of the work what we are doing. Change the file name. File, change title. Giving the name of the title as FEA tapered bar. Now if we want to see that one in the screen, so we have to do plot. Read plot, it will show lower left corner, it is showing FEA tapered bar. The name is already given. Now in finite element analysis, we are having three steps: pre-processing, processing, and post-processing. In pre-processing, what we'll do, we'll define the element type, element properties, material properties, then modeling, boundary conditions, everything will be done in pre-processing. Processing, what we'll do? Processing will solve the solution, we'll solve it, and finally post-processing, we'll get the results and analyze the results. We are starting from the preferences. Preferences, it is a static structural, so we'll click structural one. Okay, structural was done. Next one, it will be your pre-processing element type. We have to define what type of element we are giving. So nothing is defined, no element is defined. We have to add the element. So it may be different types, link, maybe different structural masses. Now suppose we are taking beam element and 3D finite strain, it is taken by default. We'll take this one. And see the number here is 1. Element type reference number is 1. This is very important. We have to remember this one. Element reference number is 1. Okay, done. We have taken beam element 3D finite strain. Element reference number is 1. It's closed. Now next one is we have to now see this beam elements will not take real constants, is not required. Now so we have to give material properties, material models. Structural, linear, elastic, isotopic. Now the thing is here, EX means modulus of elasticity. Here it is still, so it will be 2E5, that is 2 into 10 to the 5 Newton per millimeter square. 2X, while it is Poisson's ratio, so it is 0.3. Done. Next thing is, we have two sections actually. Sections we do, as it is a tapered section. Here in this case, what we are doing, we have to analyze a tapered bar. Which is having left side is having area near was equal to 1200 millimeter square, and right hand side is having area equal to 600 millimeter square, and the total length of the bar is equal to 900. So what we'll do is this total object you have to divide into three elements. So in between three elements, four nodes will be created. We have to do this one. First of all, we have to give the areas. We have to provide areas. It will come from sections, beam, common sections. Now ID number is 1. So what this is the area at the left side. This one we are considering as big area. Now, as I told, the area is equal to 1200 millimeter square. So what we'll do is we'll keep breadth equal to 40 and the height equal to 30. 40 multiplied 30 equal to 1200 millimeter square. That is the left side area applied. Okay, now next one, the right side area. Element number is 2 and the right side area is smaller one, so let's do 30 by 20 is equal to 600 millimeter square area we have provided. Element ID is 2, small area, small, the spelling is wrong, so we have to give this one as that doesn't matter actually. We can provide any name. This is small with area equal to 600 millimeter square. Okay, the two areas created. Now the thing is, we want to have a tapered bar, no? So what we'll do, we can do one thing, tapered section by XYZ locations. Now the thing is, the third one, tapered, is already done. First one is big area, second one is small area. What thing you have to do is location of the big one, that means the left side is starting from 00 origin, so here it will be 000, and the small area at 900 millimeter away. So this is given 900. Okay, done. Right? Okay. Next thing is we have to start modeling. Modeling, create elements. You have to create elements or nodes. You have to create nodes. Modeling, create. You can get keypoints also, but here we want nodes only. In active coordinate system. Now the thing is here. Here the thing is, this one is actually nodes which is created automatically. So this first one we need to provide. This is first nodes. Next it will be coming as first, second, third. It will come automatically. This is the location of the nodes. First of all, we have to create a node at the origin. So this is at the 00 location. Now this is X location, this is Y location and Z location. So as it is a one dimension only, so we have to provide only X values. Y and Z is not required. First node is created at 00. So if we don't provide here any value, by default it will take 0 value. So first node is created at 00. Now second node we want to create at 300 millimeter away from the origin. 300 millimeter away. So second node is already created, right? Now third node will create 600 millimeter away from the origin. 600, apply. Now the last node will create 900 millimeter away from the origin. 900 millimeter away. So fourth node have been created. First node at 00, second node at 300 millimeter away, third node at 600 millimeter, and fourth node at 900 millimeter away. These four nodes have been created. Now all these nodes you have to connect in the form of element. We have to connect these nodes. So we see elements, element attribute. We have created three element sections. Now we will select this one as third one, tapered bar, right? Tapered bar is selecting. And to connect these nodes through auto number through nodes, select first node and second node and then apply. So first and second node is already connected. Now select second node and third node and apply. Second and third is connected. Select third node and fourth node and OK. So all nodes have been connected in the form of elements. So we are having four nodes, node 1, node 2, node 3, node 4, and 3 elements. In between node 1 and node 2, in between node 1 and node 2, we are having first element. In between node 2 and node 3, we are having second element. And in between node 3 and node 4, we are having third element. 3 elements have been created. Now the thing is here is, we don't require to mesh it, because meshing is actually required for creating nodes. So these nodes we have already created, so meshing is not required in this case. Next part we have to do, boundary conditions we have to apply. It will come from solutions. What type of analysis you are doing? You are doing static structural analysis. Analysis type, new analysis, static structural analysis. Okay. Next part is we have to apply boundary conditions, define loads. Apply structural displacement on nodes. Structural displacement nodes. What we want to do is displacement of first node, as this one is fixed, displacement of this node should be 0. So what we are doing is selecting this node, okay, and all degrees of freedom. That means this first node in x, y, z direction, all direction, this value is 0. If you don't provide it any 0 value, by default it will take 0 value. That means the first node is having 0 displacement, okay. That means first node is fixed. It is 0 displacement in x, y, z all directions. Okay. Now next one is you have to apply force on any one of the nodes. Suppose we can apply force on second node, third node, or fourth node. But as per our requirement, let's apply a force of 5000 Newton on node number 3. We are applying a force. Let's see, apply force on nodes. Which node? We are applying on node 3. Okay. Now it is Fx, that means we are applying force in the x direction. It may be minus. If you use minus, it will be in the opposite of the x direction, towards the origin. Now 5000 node we have already applied. This is here, the red color means 5000 node is applied, which is away from the origin. Now everything is fine. We have done this one. Everything is complete. We have to solve this one. Now processing, we have to solve it. So solve current LS. Now if everything is right, it will show solution is done. So it is showing solution is done. So everything is perfect. Processing is complete. Next part, we have to go for post-processing, that means you have to see the results analysis is required. That can be done through general post-processing, right? Okay, first of all, we have to see the plot results, deform shape, deform plus undeform. It will show the original drawing plus the plus changed drawing. By the application force, the drawing has changed. That one you can see, deform, undeform. Okay, now see here, the white color is actually original drawing and the blue part is the extension. It is actually in 2D format. If you want to see this one in 3D format, what we have to do is, we have to change a little bit. We have to see plot controls, style, size and shape. Now here, the display of element is off. We have to make it on. Okay. Let's see. Now it is tapered one. Actually see, here the area is more, the area is decreasing one by one. Now to see this one in a better way, see this, see here left hand side area is more, here area is decreasing. This is actually form deform shape. Left hand side is fixed. This is the extension of the first node, not the first node, this is the first node, extension of the second node, this is the extension of the third node, this is the extension of the or displacement of the fourth node. These are the displacements of different nodes. First one is fixed, so first node is having zero displacement, second node is this much of displacement, third node this much of displacement, and fourth node is this much of displacement. This is, you can see in the form of in the graphical view. But we have to view the numbers. These things you can see also in the form of numbers. As this is one of the answers, we can save this one in the form of plot controls, capture image, file, save as. Is saved already. Is saved in the form of form deform shape. We'll close it. Okay. Next part, we have to see the extensions in the form of numbers. That will be coming from list results. List results, nodal displacements, dewey absolution, x component of displacement. That means displacement has occurred in x direction. You can see y also. Why you will have actually no displacement. So better you can see displacement x component. Let's see. Listing, it is showing first node is having zero displacement, second node is having displacement 0.69 into 20 by minus 2, and third node 0.154 into 20 by minus 1, and fourth node is having 0.15 into 20 by minus 1. These are just displacement in the form of listing numbers. Again, from the drawing also you can see these numbers. This one also we have to save it in the file. File, save as. Now what we want to see is, we want to see these displacements in the drawing itself. In the drawing is with numbers, right? That one. Plot results. Control plot. Nodal solution. Dewey absolution. X component of displacement. Okay, see these things are displacement. See here, these are the displacements of defined nodes. What we have seen in the listing, these are the same things actually. This is the displacements at different nodes. Okay, again, as this is one of the answers, so we have to save this part in the plot controls. Capture image, file, save as. Now we want to see stresses developed at different elements. So we have to see elemental stresses. First element, second element, different elements. What are the stresses developed? You can see this one again. How to do this one? Element table, we have to form it. Element table, define table. Nothing is defined, so we have to add it. Add. Okay. So this, what we want to do, we have to check stress. We will write down stress. Now one thing is, for checking the stress, what we have to do is come down by sequence number here, and it will LS stress. And at the beginning we told that element reference number is 1, so we have to provide this LS 1, element reference number is 1. This is 1. Okay, done. Close. Now we have to see the results. Plot element table, stress is there. Okay. This is the stresses in the form of numbers. This is also, we can see, in the form of numbers. This is one of the answers, so we have to save this part. Plot controls, capture image. File save as can provide any name and save it this one in the first folder what we created before. This is saved. Again, the same thing you can see in the form of numbers, that is listing. List element table. Stress, we will see the results. Stress. Stress of the first element is equal to 4.6 Newton per millimeter square. Second is 5.7 Newton per millimeter square. Third one is negative stress 0.13 × −14. This is the stresses at different elements. So maximum stress is 5.7 × 143. These are the stresses. And this is all about this finite element analysis of a tapered bar. We have seen stresses at different elements and also nodal displacement, displacement of different nodes, first node, second node, third node, fourth node. We have seen all these things in the form of drawings, also in the form of figures. By the same time, we have seen in the form of listing numbers. And by the same time, we have seen maximum displacement also, maximum stresses of different elements. This is finite element analysis of a tapered bar. Thank you.